Most scientists are out replicating the work of others. But a good scientist is someone that's at the tip of the spear, really trying to drive the field forward. And I think in order to be a great scientist, you have to be a little playful. You have to look for the odd observations, the things that everybody else just takes for granted. You have to say, well, no, that doesn't really make sense. But you also have to know when to let go. So you don't want to just take a concept and beat your head against a wall forever once you realize that, well, you know, maybe I'm wrong and that's not going to work.
Technical work, even creative technical work, can start to feel very much the same, like you're trying to solve the same problems. As I gain expertise in things, I start to lose the wonder that I had at the beginning, and I start to become more aware of what you can't do. And so I always like to make sure that in some aspects of my life, I'm back at the really steep part of the learning curve, that I am comfortable with being a beginner, that I am comfortable with thinking outside of the ways in which I usually think in my work.
Oftentimes, when people say something's impossible, they say, well, I can't imagine that really happening personally. The naysayers think that they've discovered something when they've found some difficulty. Actually, they've just helped us map it out.
Breakthroughs are very hard to schedule. You know, you don't have the option of saying, okay, I'm going to work on this for a little while, and then there's going to be this brilliant flash of insight, and I'll move forward. But often, I think what I have found in the places where I've had the most success, it's in taking the time to really understand and pose the problem. And then you get that moment that now says, okay, I can see what the path is that I got to go and move forward on.
Where are we in our society right now that seems to create a kind of extreme anxiety about risk, trying to do anything where maybe you don't know the outcome? How do you have a stable, sustainable society, a safe society that still fosters people with a kind of revolutionary, subversive mindset? I don't know the answer.
All new technologies, all new things that you're trying to do, any problem that's worthwhile solving carries some kind of risk associated with it. I mean, if it didn't, it wouldn't be worth solving.
When things are placed, barriers are placed in front of us to overcome, those are opportunities for us to grow and to be even stronger and better.
It's a way of implicitly asking the question, why not? You know, why don't we think of projects like that as being sort of normal ideas within our grasp, things that we could be undertaking today?